Azure Site Recovery can help you protect important applications by coordinating the replication and recovery of private clouds across sites, whether you're protecting dozens or hundreds of virtual machines. You can protect your applications to your own second site, a hoster's site, or even use Azure as your disaster recovery site and avoid the expense and complexity of building and managing your own secondary location. Here we have the Azure Site Recovery dashboard. Under Usage Overview, you can see that we not only have a number of Contoso VMs protected between our on-premises locations, but also we have a number of VMs being replicated into Microsoft Azure. Within Protected Items, you'll see we have a number of protected clouds, all existing on-premises, managed by System Center, with the Finance Primary Cloud being replicated to Microsoft Azure. If we drill into this Finance Primary Cloud, you'll see there are a number of important workloads that are currently being protected. These include file server, app, and database, along with web front-end workloads, all of which are critical to the finance department. All of these have been centrally configured for replication using Azure Site Recovery. They're all currently running on-premises, but are ready for failover in the event of an outage. You'll also notice the different target sizes. Azure Site Recovery automatically configures the target VM size in Azure as closely as it can to that of the on-premises version. However, you can override this on a VM by VM basis if required. Now, if we look at the configuration, you can see that our replication and recovery target is Microsoft Azure. We specify a subscription and storage account that we want to use to store the important data. You'll also notice we provide the flexibility and granularity that IT pros are looking for, with support for encryption of data at rest, ensuring you can meet your regulatory and compliance requirements. And if we scroll down, you'll see we have replication intervals down to every 30 seconds, or 5 minutes, or 15 minutes, up to 24 additional recovery points, and the ability to take app-consistent VSS snapshots. You'll also see I can replicate the initial data immediately or at a later time, perhaps outside of business hours. So let's go back. Now, one of the most complex parts of configuring a solution for disaster recovery is networking. However, with Azure Site Recovery, it's incredibly simple. Firstly, I'll select my on-premises data center managed by System Center. Then I'll select my target, which in this case is Microsoft Azure. This is where I want to map my on-premises networks into. You'll see a list of networks on-premises and a single pre-created, already mapped virtual network, in this case, backend, that exists in Azure. I just need to map one more so that in the event of a failover, my workloads can communicate as expected. So I'll choose the Finance Primary. I'll choose Map. I select my target subscription, in this case pay-as-you-go, and I'll select my target Azure network, in this case Finance DR, and click OK. Simple as that, we've now mapped our networks so that when workloads fail over into Azure, they can communicate as expected. So now we have our VMs replicated and protected and networks mapped. How do we ensure that when VMs fail over, they do so in a controlled and orchestrated manner? Because the last thing an IT pro wants to have to do in the event of an outage is start up VMs one by one manually. And that's where recovery plans come in. So let's go to recovery plans. And here you'll see we have a couple. I'm going to drill into the finance recovery plan. Now, if we explore one of these a little deeper, you'll see that a recovery plan consists of a series of steps executed in a particular order. Firstly, in the event of a planned failover, where the primary site is still online, you'll see that all VMs are shut down cleanly, which will ensure that any final delta changes can be replicated up to Azure. When we expand Group 1, first you'll see our database virtual machines are failed over and brought online in Azure. Now, you'll also see as part of this group, I've added a post step, specifically a script execution, which if we drill in and have a look through Edit Script, you'll see this script is a PowerShell-based runbook stored within the Azure Automation Service that will be called at the appropriate time during the recovery plan. In this case, the script will perform some SQL Server specific actions against the database servers that have just been failed over. Let's close that. If we expand Group 2, you'll see that our file server VMs are then failed over, and Group 3, our application servers. And if we scroll down, we expand Group 4, you'll see our web front ends are then failed over, which required the other servers to be up and running first for these to successfully fail over and start as expected. You'll also notice I've added a post step here for this particular group. In this case, it's a manual action, which if we take a look, you'll see in this case it requires somebody to physically do something before the process continues. In this case, it's asking the application owner to confirm the expected functionality. So we can close that. Now, before we execute or initiate a failover, you'll see it's possible to test failover. In this case, all we do will be to select a virtual network in Azure that we want to use for the test failover and supply our encryption key because we're using the encryption of data at rest. And you can test as often as you like. But let's close there and let's go for a planned failover just to show you how easy it is to initiate a failover. My primary site is still online, hence why I've chosen to go with a planned failover. Now, as I'm using encryption of data at rest, I'll need to supply my encryption key, just like that, very straightforward, and then click OK. And just like that, we started the failover process from on-premises into Microsoft Azure. Because this is a cloud service presented in HTML5, this could have been triggered from my PC, my tablet, my smartphone, or even my Xbox. That's the power of Microsoft Azure and Azure Site Recovery.